My interest in working with cancer comes from two sources. First, cancer is a very large humanitarian problem that affects a large number of people and is only going to grow in incidence as the population ages. And second, it's a very interesting evolutionary problem because it's not something that makes us sick because of a foreign agent that infects us. It's our own cells that go awry and act in a way in which they shouldn't. My name is Franziska Michor. I'm currently a professor of computational biology at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute and the Harvard School of Public Health. I grew up in Vienna in Austria, and it was a great childhood. My parents played a big role in my interest in math and science. My dad is a mathematician, and he always showed my sister and I that being a scientist is a great career choice. But we also had our mom at home, and she is a nurse. So she worked with patients in the hospital every day to try to make them feel better. And it demonstrated to us that just the pure pursuit of knowledge isn't sufficient. You also need to make the world a better place. So I decided to combine those two and to use my technical skill with the ultimate goal of trying to cure cancer. I started my scientific career as an undergraduate in Vienna, where I studied mathematics and molecular biology. Then I came to the United States to do my PhD in evolutionary theory. I currently run a lab of about 10 people investigating the evolutionary dynamics of cancer treatment, response, progression, and metastasis. My work differs from conventional cancer research in that it uses quantitative methods to a large extent, and it also uses a viewpoint of evolutionary biology to try to understand cancer. So I see cancer as an evolutionary problem in that a population of individual cells undergoes variation that could be epigenetic or genetic variation, and those are the changes that emerge in cancer cells as they become progressively more aggressive. I'm hoping that the work I'm doing will leave a mark on the world and that it will show us a path towards making cancer research more quantitative and more predictive, and that we'll learn how to formulate mathematical frameworks of how cancer cells behave and respond to interventions that we throw at them in order to ultimately have a predictive explanatory understanding of the biology of cancer. My experience as an Austrian immigrant working and living in the United States has been great. It's a place full of opportunity. The great part of this journey has been that it's always unclear what lies ahead, and the world is full of possibilities. I can only be excited about the future. I don't know what it will bring.